Hello, my name is Martin Inhofer. I'm the inventor of Zamat, and today I want to give you an introduction into Zamat. So let's start with the agenda. What is Zamat? Zamat is a help desk and support platform for satisfied customer service. Zamat is open and fast, like your service should be. Zamat is based on many years of experience with ticketing systems. A side note, I'm also the inventor of OTRS. And the meaning of Zamat comes from the Bavarian dialect, together we are stronger. So it means together with the customer we find a solution. Some numbers. The initial release of Zamat was in 2016. Today we count over 540 downloads. We are trending open source project in category Ruby on GitHub. The first contribution after initial release was just 5 hours after initial release. We count 249 pull requests, and the last number where we proud of the first award we received just 4 weeks after initial release, and the second award we got 16 weeks after initial release. The key features. Zamat is a native web app. It feels almost like a desktop app because it's a native web application and the application itself runs in the browser and we use modern JavaScript and HTML5. We have a super fast full text search which also includes attachments. So you can easily find tickets by searching content of attachments. Every resource can be reached via REST API by design. This reason is easy because it's a native web application which is just using REST as a REST API and WebSockets. But for you, it means you easily can create integrations with other services because the REST API is available by design. And last but not least, Zamat is open source. The core features in the ticketing area, we support autosave for tickets, we have an easy data historization, we support escalations and SLAs, we have collision detection, this means no answering tickets with two agents at the same time and different answers. We support custom overviews based on ticket attributes. We support individual fields for tickets, customers, and users. We have a nice customer chat widget. We have custom text templates, which can be used via shortcuts. And we have integration to social media networks like Twitter and Facebook. How about the installation? The installation is a quite easy process. We provide OS packages for CentOS, Red Hat Enterprise Linux, Debian, Ubuntu, and SLES. Databases, we support Postgres, MySQL, and MariaDB. And as search engines, we support Elasticsearch. By the way, this is the reason why the Zamat search is so unbelievable fast. The installation itself are four commands, and it's no big hack. You do not need to install additional libraries or something else, so it can be done within 5 or 6 minutes. If you want to run Elasticsearch, which we really recommend, you have to execute another 7 commands. And after these 7 commands, you have a full integration of Elasticsearch into Zamat. So it's also done quite easy. After the installation is done, Zamat will say hello with a welcome screen. And in this welcome screen, you can decide if you want to set up a new system or if you want to migrate from another system like OTRS or Zendesk. Yeah, so let's get further working with the app. So the structure of Zamat is on the left top, you have a global search. Beside, on the right side of this box, you have the SAMAT notifications. So important here is you get the notifications in SAMAT itself. So you have the possibility to still receive it via email, but you also can remove it. So no more bombing of notifications via email. Below we have the dashboard and the overviews. Overviews are some kind of to-do lists for agents. So they have lists of tickets where they can work on it. And next to overviews, we have the summer tabs. I will go into these tabs a little bit deeper right after this screen. And on the right side, we have a typical ticket view. A typical content view. In this case, it's a ticket in detail view. In the middle, we have the articles and right the ticket attributes. But go deeper. Let's have a look deeper to the summer tabs. So to support the agent to have the life easier for him, we support multiple tabs at same time, so the agent can switch between tickets and can start answering the first ticket, and in the meantime he need to respond something else or somebody else has a question, so the agent can switch between multiple objects and at same time. The agent can reorder these tabs like the agent want. Unsaved changes are saved on server side, so no more losing data when a browser is crashed, or it's also possible to change the whole device. For example, you can log in from home and you can continue working where you stopped at work and nothing was losing. If somebody else is changing an object, we get pulsing icons on changes, so the agent is seeing if somebody else has changed the ticket and he did not see the ticket in the meantime. Changes are pushed immediately to the client, so we have some, let's call it, real-time functionality, so no page reload or something else is needed. If somebody else is changing something, the other clients will see it immediately. And last but not least, we introduced ring traffic lights to support the agent. We found out it's a good way to show him the initial or the current state of a ticket by using colors. And let's go through these colors to give you a short impression. So we have the orange color. This means the ticket is new or open, and somebody needs to work on it. So somebody needs to see what is the next step and need to set the next steps for this ticket. We have the gray, dark gray color. This means the ticket is pending reminder or pending close, but this time is not reached till now. So no further actions for the agent. It's important. No further actions or attention is needed right now. We have the red color, which means the ticket is escalated. This is some kind of warning. Somebody need to work immediately on this ticket to cancel this escalation. And the last color is green. Green means the ticket is closed. No, for the agent, it means no further action is needed. And he can go read this ticket or go through whatever, but the case is already closed. Here is the ticket details. Here it is important in the content area. In the middle part, we see the different articles which are representing the communication. On the right side, we see three tabs, and the first tab we see the ticket attributes, and the next one you would see the customer information, and on the last one the organization information of the customer. A typical customer detail view looks like this. So you have the ticket, the customer attributes, and below you have the tickets of this customer. Here we distinguish between open and closed tickets, and as you already know now, this customer is quite relaxing because only closed tickets are available for this user, and you see this by the color green. So the agent is relaxing by watching this screen. The next one is the organization in detail. So several customers you can combine to an organization or department. And here is it's similar. You see the attributes of the organization, then the members of the organization, and below you see the tickets of this organization. How about the full text search, which I was mentioned? So when we published or released Summit version 1, we did a short research how about to get an impression about this good full text search of Summit. So we installed several systems, several competitors, and we created tickets in it, and then we measured the time, and you see if the installation is a small installation with 50,000 tickets, it's similar. You see Summit is fast, but the competitors also fast. But if the system is growing and you have a bigger system, like with 500,000 tickets, and the database then is about 54 gigabytes, then you see the average help desk system will take about 40 seconds, and Summit is still delivering the search results within 4 seconds. Yeah. A short overview about the key features in the UI here for the agents. Here you see the overviews in detail. As I already mentioned, overviews are some kind of to-do lists where the agent will find tickets where the agent need to work on it. These overviews can be created individually, and also the attributes and the ordering and so on, the naming, you can define by yourself. Another nice feature is the permanent markup. So it's like a text marker. You can select text within an article, and you can mark it. So the use case is that another agent will find important information of one ticket or of one article easier. Here, a really powerful feature, it's called text modules. So when you reply to a customer, you can insert text modules by using double point and then the search phrase. So you will see a selection of text modules which are matching your search phrase, and if you by enter or using click on this text module, you can take over this text module to the response. So for power agents, you see 10 seconds just keyboard clicking, and then a nice formatted answer is created and sent out to the customer. By the way, this is also a nice way for technical people which are not so usually not so familiar with writing nice text, but with this text modules also technical people can consume and write nice readable texts to customers. Also, we also support macros. A short use case, if you connected a mailbox to Summit, you will get spam emails someday, and spam emails usually get closed. The owner is assigned to me and I take it for as spam. So with this macros, you can execute several sequences, action sequences on this ticket by executing this macro. So it will save time for agents, and if you execute this macro, the state is set automatically, the owner is set automatically, and the tag is assigned to this ticket automatically. So it's time-saving functionalities, so to give the agent the time to work on the real tickets and not on this spam tickets, for example. Yeah, here are screenshot of the individual fields. So as I already mentioned in the admin interface, you can manage or create individual fields for tickets, users, organizations, and groups. Typical individual field is a category of a ticket to see what kind of tickets you have. And if you do a reporting later, you can improve your services or your time which you spend, or for example, you find out your documentation is bad. So it's a good tool, a ticket category, to find out how to improve your services. As next, I want to show you setting up channels. I want to show you the integration of an email channel. So it is important we do auto discovery and we support IMAP, POP3, and SMTP. So if you go to the admin interface, to the channels area and to the email area, you just need to enter your email address and your password, and usually Xamarin will automatically detect the server settings, and usually it works on 95%. But sometimes it will not work because it's not possible to detect the server settings automatically, then you need to enter your settings by yourself, so your server settings, but usually you can connect your mailbox within 2 or 3 minutes and your team mailbox, and you can start using this team mailbox really fast. The next channel, which I want to show you today, is the chat channel. And here we found out that we need to take care on 4 different topics which we want to improve. And the first one is integration. So we decided to have easy integration. So we have done it via a JavaScript snippet. You will see it later. The next one, we got feedback from users that it's a bad UX for showing a chat widget, but if you click on the chat widget, you get the message, nobody's available for chatting, please leave a message. So we decided to not show the chat widget when no agent is available for chatting. The next one was the users complained about long waiting times. So with SummerChat, your customers will not have long waiting times because we have each agent can say if the agent is available for chatting. And if an agent is not responding, Xamarin will set this agent automatically to not available. So he will not receive further chats, which means that you can reduce the waiting times just by misleading information because the agent is not available. He's gone to lunch or whatever, and nobody knows about that, but Xamarin will recognize this and will remove the availability of the agent for chats. And last but not least, many customers complained about the chat widget feels like a fortune body in the web application. So for this, we designed or implemented the auto design mode. So Xamarin is creating a nice looking design by automatically. And how it works, you can see here. If you want to integrate the chat widget on your website, you go to the Xamarin admin interface, to the channels, and then to the chat. You immediately see a preview. This preview is done by using the domain of the current user, of the email address domain, and Xamarin is grabbing the web page of this domain and is using our auto design mode and shows you how the chat widget would look like. So usually Xamarin is doing a really good job here, but if for some reason the colors are not the colors which you want, you can, for example, select other colors of your web page here And also the kind, how the design is and so on is detected by Samad automatically. But how to get this auto-designed chat widget now on your website? This is also quite easy. On the second part of this admin area, you see what you have to do. You just need this JavaScript snippet and you need to copy it to your web page source content. And then the chat is available. And for this auto design mode, we are a little bit proud. So in the implementation phase, we did it with the important 100 web pages on the world. And here a short, a little impression how it looks like. And all of these chat widgets are designed or created by auto design mode. So you usually you can take it just one to one and paste it to your website and it will look like a native element of your website. Yeah. Now, as you may already heard, there is also a Nextcloud integration of Xamarin. I want to give you a short overview here. So if you install the Nextcloud integration on your Nextcloud environment, you have the possibility to have your Xamarin notifications in your Nextcloud dashboard and also in the normal classic notifications. So if you work in this Nextcloud UI and you see and Xamarin, you get a Xamarin notification, you also can see it here and can react to your tickets easier or faster. And also important, it's also possible to search for tickets by using the Nextcloud UI. So if there is a search provider implemented, and if you search for certain content, not only the Nextcloud documents are used, also the Xamarin backend is used, and you see probably what tickets are related to your search stuff. Yeah, now I want to say thank you. I wish you a nice day, and hopefully see you soon, and say hopefully I see you soon as Xamarin user. So have a nice day.